The kingdom of God has suffered violence, and the for the weak, but it's for men and women who are willing to say, we are going to fight. How do we fight? Our fight is not against flesh and blood, but we have given power to fight every principality. Now, when creation was completed, you see, whenever I'm invited somewhere, I always want to know, God, where did we go wrong? Because at times we are praying, we are fasting, we are doing all sorts of things that are biblical, but we have not solved the equation. Thank you, God, where did we go wrong? Now today we are fighting gender. You know, we are fighting. There was never a time where we could say that our husbands are abusing us, our men are killing us, our women have lost their positions, they have forgotten how to submit. When you start reading such things, you get to wonder that, God, what did we do wrong? Now, the Bible says in the book of Nehemiah, Nehemiah is told that the gates of Jerusalem are bent down. The walls are down as we speak. Now, whenever the Bible speaks of security, you have to understand that something moved, and now we are vulnerable unto the enemy. I said, God, what is happening? Would you want to go to that? Now protection is no longer there. When protection is not there, the Bible says Nehemiah cried. He wept. But I want you to understand the prayer of Nehemiah. The Bible says at this time Nehemiah was serving at the citadel of Susa as a cup bearer. Now Nehemiah was not part of the scene of Israel at that time. Now the Bible says when he heard, Hafabada Mutimo Nekisio, Mutimo Hayaba born, but he stands in the camp. Are Mutimo, Haraya Zahan. Now we need people today who will say, Father, Nezele Matahanke, if our president is not doing right, remember, now we have been given dominion. If he can't plead for forgiveness for this country, the book of Lamentation, my goodness, God, you will read it at home because I want us to pray. The book of Lamentation, when Jeremiah writes this book, I believe at this time Israel was going through what we are going through, because injustice was seen so much in this book. You even read in this book that women would think, tomorrow. Now the book of Lamentation, I normally say it's a book of horror, because if a parent can slaughter their own kids because they are hungry, now this book addresses poverty at its extreme. This book addresses every killing that you can think of, because human slaughter, you get it in the book of Lamentation. Severe poverty, you get it in the book of Lamentation. Ruthless leaders, you get it in the book of Lamentation. But the Bible says, instead of God raising a judge, not a president, he says to Jeremiah, call me worthy. Women, who might have an affair, but your Emma Sahu, Baramutimu, Honeka. When you go back to the book of Genesis, I love this word smells the incense that Noah took up to him. I believe you have been praying, and we are praying in different denominations. But the Bible says, when the Lord saw that they were in unity and the incense was made God, for the first time in the Bible, we hear God saying, never again, never again will I allow my children to go through such a pain. Now we cause him to change his mind. Even though the fact that was predestined for our South Africa, the fact that we are standing together, I hear God saying never and never again. My goodness, God, my late president, Nelson Mandela, he understood that he had to speak in power and authority. And he said, never and never again. Now this morning, I want to say, as we all stand up, you just say never again to our children abused, never again to Nyaube, never again to injustice, never and never again will we see fathers moving from their positions, never again will our children continue to abort their kids, even if the children are not ordained by God, never again will HIV and AIDS struggle our country, never again will cancer surpass the blood